Peace. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. For those who don't know, it's your boy Vic Slang Hope, and tonight I come to share with you the story of the night of my shooting. But before I do that, I want you to go ahead, like, comment, subscribe. That's how, like, I keep my information circulating and stuff like that. And before I get into, like, the story of the night of my shooting, I gotta tell you what led up to the shooting. So one night, me and a couple of my boys, we set out to go purchase a firearm. You know, not because we was bad individuals, we just lived in a neighborhood that, you know, you had to defend yourself, right? And like everybody else was buying guns. Shit, we done even got shot at a few times. So, you know, it was imperative that, you know, we leveled the playing field. And leveling the playing field, you know, when you live in certain communities like that, means you gotta have some type of like artillery or weaponry that other people have too, right? You know, just trying to protect yourself and your family and your loved ones. So anyway, we set out to get a firearm. We got a firearm. We came back to the neighborhood, and then one of my friends, he was saying that like he wanted to test the firearm, and I was telling him like, bro, no, the hood is hot today, like there's a lot of police presence or whatever, like, you know, you should just leave it and whatever the case might be, and, you know, just go about business, test it some other day. Testing, like, just means, you know, you could just shoot it in the air, make sure it works, or stuff like that. So anyway, this individual was persistent and didn't want to take heed to the advice that I was trying to give him. So I said, all right, fine, have it your way. He takes the firearm, walks down the block, and him and a few others of my friends were together, and the police, they encountered the police, and the police locked all of them up. And the individual that was persistent ended up saying that the gun belonged to another one of my friends. At least that's how I believe things transpire, you know. People try to say different things went down, but I believe that was the situation. So that happened, and then now I got word of it about what happened, and at the end of the day it was only my fingerprints on the firearm and the individual that I gave it to. We the only two people that touched the gun. And then when I went down the block to further investigate, people told me that they seen the same individual I gave the gun to with the gun before the police arrested them. So it didn't make sense how my other friend that never touched the weapon got hit with the gun charge. You know, but anyway, this is not the story about that, right? So, you know, fast forward. That was the situation, and I was just letting people know in the neighborhood, like, yo, this dude is a rat, he's no good. Like, you know, this is what happened. And then people were like talking about there's no paperwork, X, Y, Z, you need proof. And I'm just like, ah, everybody started playing the politic games, right? Everybody became politicians in that moment. So I still was like telling people, like, I spread the word, and then like the individual felt some type of way about me. And I felt like the individual came home from being incarcerated for like a week, right? And had like some type of like vengeance towards me. And, you know, there was some hostility. There was certain messages that were being sent to me about like what was gonna happen, you know, when the individual came home and got released. So this individual happens to show up at my house on the day of his release. And he shows up with a different individual that I don't know. So I believe this individual was hostile, and I took it that way, right? You know, we live in the hood, you know what I'm saying? So it's like when you hear certain shit or people saying certain things, you're going to take it a certain way. So, you know, long story short, I ended up bumping into this individual the same day that he showed up to my house in the street. And I was, you know, a few friends were around, and I ended up bumping to this individual, you know, some words were said. And long story short, I ended up shooting the individual in the face. Now, I'm not saying that to brag, to boast. I'm saying that, like, in the moment, I felt like the situation required that. I felt like, you know, in order, like, to help myself and my friends, and I felt like it was the lesser of the evils, right? And it's fucked up, you know what I'm saying, that, like, you know, we got people out here that have to be in certain predicaments like that, right? And I know a lot of people be like, oh, you could leave, you could do this, you could do so many different things, but like sometimes people don't have a way to flee, right? They don't have a different place to go to, they don't have like money to move, they don't have the resources, right, to have different options. So in that moment, I felt like the best bet was to like eliminate this threat, right? That was a threat to like me, my friends, and everybody. So that was the actions that I took. And it's crazy because in the hood, like it always seems to be like some shit going on, or people always seem to be put in a predicament of like, you know, either you're gonna fight or you're gonna flee, right? Fight or flight. And then it's like sometimes flight doesn't even feel like an option because, you know, a lot of times we living in moments of ignorance and unaware of a lot of different things. So in my time of ignorance, that's the course that I chose to take. And I felt like it was the best thing at the moment. And then after that, I ended up getting like incarcerated like 2 days later or three, due to some more cooperation. The individual that I shot, he cooperated with the police again, and I ended up going to jail. But before I went to jail, after the shooting, the friends of the individual, you know, they started threatening me and calling my phone and saying that it wasn't safe for me and my mother and like, you know, all these type of different things, right? And it's like, when I think about it now, I'm like, damn. I'm like, I exposed my mom to like harm. I exposed myself to harm. And in the moment, like, I felt justified, right? In the moment, I was like, yeah, nobody gonna do nothing to me. Nobody's gonna harm my mother. Nobody's gonna show up to my house and think it's gonna be all good. And like, but I'm not really thinking about like, I expose my family to this, right? I put myself in this situation. But like, sometimes again, like I said, when you're not exposed, when your brain is not exposed to different things, different avenues, different means, it could be that way. And you know, like my mindset when these individuals started threatening me, my mindset was just like, okay, I'm just gonna get more guns. They're not gonna win this war, you know. And but at the same time, I felt like it was dangerous. It was dangerous for me. It was dangerous for like other people. And I felt like it just created a worse situation, you know. And yeah, after that, I ended up getting locked up. I went to jail, and you know, the things kept going on. So this whole situation, like this whole stuff, just led to like other things, you know. Me thinking that I could just get rid of a situation, taking one course of action, just kind of like created a whole bunch of other things. So I left some details out because, you know, they're not really necessary, but like, you know, I just wanted to share with the people and share some of like my experiences and, you know, my walks of life. 'Cause like G Herbo said, right? He said something about, he said, if you don't live how he live, you can't feel a man, you know? So a lot of times people be like, I feel you, bro. I feel you, sis. I feel you. But it's like, we all got different experiences. And it's like, you might wanna understand and feel where a person's coming from. But it's like, if you didn't go through that same path, it's very hard for somebody to be able to feel that person. And sometimes some of us do go down the same path and we still don't feel that person because, you know, we all different complex individuals. But let me know what y'all think. Would y'all have done something different? You know, just kind of like brainstorming to see like what different ideas or what different things or suggestions or people, you know, it happened already, but like I would like to hear like certain things that people might feel like, oh, I would have done this different or I would have done that, you know. So let me know. Comment.